This morning, amen, I want to talk to you about the resurrection life. I am the resurrection and life. I want to take you to a scene just weeks prior to him going to the cross. His good friend Lazarus has passed away. They had sent word to Jesus, and by the way, they told him that Lazarus was sick prior to this. And he remained still 3 days in the city that he was in without responding. And finally, he told his disciples, he said, we'll go now. Lazarus is asleep, meaning that he's passed. And you might say, well, why does he go now? Why does he all of a sudden delayed his time to go, and now he's decided to go? Lazarus is dead. See, in our humanistic way, we would think all hope is lost. Right? Why would we even respond? Why even bother now? Apparently, probably many of them thought the same thing. Why even bother now? Keep on doing what you're doing. And I believe a lot of times when we get in an earnest need for God, we begin to pray and we begin to reach out to him, and he delays his response to us. And a lot of times, we get in that mindset, why even bother anymore? I prayed and I prayed and I sought God, and he refused to respond to me, so just forget it. Have you ever thought that maybe, just maybe, he was trying to get you to think and trust him and believe him at his word? Have you ever thought that? That maybe he's testing your faith to see if you really trust him and believe in him? As he made his journey, and when he gets near, when we see in John's gospel, I mean, Luke maybe, John 11. And when he gets there, he began to listen to the sob stories of Mary and Martha. Mary came to Jesus in verse 32 and saw him, and she fell down at his feet, saying unto him, Lord, if thou had been here, my brother would have not died. Jesus therefore saw her weeping, and the Jews also weeping which came with her, and he groaned in the spirit and was troubled. And he said to her, where have you laid him? They said unto him, Lord, come and see. And the Bible said in verse 35 that Jesus wept. Some said maybe he's crying because of his friend's death. I think he was crying because of their disbelief in him. I think he saw the people's heart and how heavy it was, and he was moved with compassion, but I believe that he cried because they doubted him. They doubted him because if you read on in verse 25 there, back up a little bit, he said unto Martha, he said, I am the resurrection and the life, and he that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. I believe he cried because they did not believe that very thing, that he was the resurrection and the life. They didn't take him at his word. They didn't trust him at his word. They didn't believe him. And I believe that's why he wept. That's my personal opinion. You might have a different view than I, but that's all right, because the main fact is that he is the resurrection and the life, and he's about to prove it. He's about to prove it. Because, see, if we've been following in John, and if you read the book of John, you will find out he said, I am the bread of life. And everybody knows that you got to have some bread, don't you? Amen. To have life. Amen. Glory to God. I mean, I like to eat. And some of you like to eat. I see that you, amen, are eating fine and well because, amen, you're plump and ripe. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. And I tell you what, amen, he is the bread of life. And if we have to have physical food to sustain our bodies down here, amen, and give us life and energy, then friend, you and I, amen, need to eat the bread of life. Glory to God, that'll give us some spiritual energy that we can haul. Whoa! Glory to God, amen. Whoa! Glory to God. I'm like Ric Flair today. Whoa! Amen. Y'all remember Ric Flair, amen. That old wrestler, he droopy now. He was strong, amen. He all droopy now. But glory to God, he was a man. He was, woo, amen. Throw that blonde hair back, you know, and strut, amen. Why can't we throw if I had some hair, I'd throw it back today and praise Jesus, amen. Yeah, praise the Lord. I am the bread of life, he said in John 6:37. Amen, take a part of me, amen. Amen. Absorb it in your life. Believe me at my word. Trust me by faith. And you can see magnificent things. Amen. He said, I am the bread of life. I am the light of the world. And everybody needs a light, don't they? Don't want to walk around in darkness too long, because that's terrifying. Have you ever walked in the dark? You don't know what's in the dark. You don't know what you'll trip on. You don't know what you'll fall on. And glory to God, let me tell you this, of the dark world that we're living in. And if you ain't careful, if you walk in that darkness, you're going to trip up and you're going to fall and you're going to get hurt. And matter of fact, amen, you could lose your life. For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life. He illuminates that, amen. He brings it to life. Glory to God, when you turn on a light, you see all kinds of things, don't you? Because light illuminates things. And it exposes things that shouldn't be there. And that's what the gospel does. It exposes, amen, the sinfulness of darkness in our life. And shows us what's there. And that it's rotten to the core and needs to be get rid of. Somebody say amen. That's why Jesus died on the cross, wasn't it? Amen, glory to God. That's why he died on the cross, wasn't it? To save us from our sins. To save us from being tripped up, amen, and destroyed and killed by Satan in the darkness. He illuminates. And then he said, I'm the door. Everybody, amen, came in a door this morning. Matter of fact, amen, you left your house, you went through a door. Hopefully. You went through a door. You got in a car, you opened the door and got in, didn't you? And closed the door. And when you got out on the parking lot, amen, you opened the door. Came through the way of the door. You came into this church, you came in the door. Jesus said, if you're going to go into heaven, you got to come through the door, and I am the door. Says that over in John 10:9. I am the door. He said, I'm the light of the world in John 8:12. And then he says this. I am a good shepherd, and a good shepherd cares for his sheep. We are the sheep of God. We are the sheep of God. He's our good shepherd. Matter of fact, we read a psalm on every funeral, just basic, but almost every funeral you'll hear the 23rd psalm, the Lord is my shepherd, right? But Jesus said over in John's gospel, he said, I'm the good shepherd. And a good shepherd cares for his sheep like none other. I'm glad that Jesus, amen, takes care of me. Glory to God, he's been taking care of this old boy for 60 years. I know I don't look like 60 years old. But, you know, I've been here 60 years, and God is taking care of me every step of the way. And everything I got, amen, is because of him. Everything I got. I know tomorrow it could all be gone. But you know, they can take all the material things away, but they can't take Jesus out of my heart. And Jesus will always make sure I have what I need. He'll make sure I'll have what I need. Over in Philippians, it tells me that. Philippians chapter 4 tells me that my God shall supply all of my needs according to his riches in glory. And I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Glory to God, I am glad of that because he is my good shepherd. And here in John's gospel, he's my resurrection and life. Oh, Lazarus has been dead for 4 days. They done put him in the grave. Matter of fact, they say he stinketh by now. It didn't make any difference because, see, if you believe, he told Martha, he said, I am the resurrection and the life, and he that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And I like what he said in the next verse, because the next verse is very important to you and I. If we don't believe, amen, we'll never have eternal life. He said, and whosoever liveth and believeth in me, he shall never die. And he asked this question to her, believest thou this? And he's asking you and I today, do we believe it? Do you believe he is the resurrection and the life? Do you believe? Because he that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. Believe. My God, I have never seen a dead man come up out of the graveyard. If I did, I'd probably end up in the graveyard. Hello? Come on, you will too. If a dead man started walking through the doors of this church, amen, you know he was dead. You've seen him buried. And glory to God, he come walking through that door. I know Cecil's a big man, but he'd probably pass out. Yeah. Come on, amen, let's get real. But Jesus said, if you believe, all things are possible. If you believe, if you trust me, if you have faith, faith is a substance of things hoped for, evidence of not things not yet seen. Glory to God, Mary and Martha had to have a heart and a faith, and they had to believe in who he said he was. I am the resurrection and the life. Because they're about to see something ain't nobody seen before. A dead man been in the graveyard for 4 days. Come back to life. Jesus said, where have you laid him? He says, remove the stone. I see some Baptist folks in the crowd. What do you think he's going to do? That man been dead 4 days. Kind of preacher he think he is. Y'all have seen them folks in church. Huh? Who does he think he is? Ain't only in the Baptist church either. They're in all churches. I just use Baptist because we is one. Amen. All right. Let me tell you, there's doubters in every crowd. He said, move the stone. Move the stone. Believe me. Believe me. He said, Lazarus! He called him by name. And I know you sitting there wondering, why did he call him by name? Because if he didn't, everybody else in the cemetery would come out. I am the resurrection and the life, he said. I am the resurrection and the life. Come out of that grave, Lazarus. Come out of that grave. Wouldn't you like to be standing by? I bet you they'll holler at Scott Stadium then, Chris, amen. When they seen a dead man start coming up out of the dirt, amen, and out of the crevices of that tomb, and here he comes out with grave clothes on. I bet your crowd parted, amen, like the Red Sea. Don't y'all? Some of you, some fell asleep again. You didn't get that. I said, I bet you the crowd departed like the Red Sea. I bet you the doubters passed out. Probably had to fill some of the holes, amen, up with them because they done died on the spot, Don. Amen. They dead as a doornail. Amen. Because, amen, the dead came back to life. Jesus said, loose him and let him go. Loose him and let him go. You think Lazarus, amen, after being dead 4 days, jumped out of that graveyard and went over there and sat on a stump and fell asleep. I think he was hooping in a holler. Praise God, my buddy showed up, amen, and showed off. I'm alive and well, hallelujah, amen. Don't you think he did that? I bet he parted some crowds, amen, on his way into the city, hollering and a hooping and a carrying on, because, amen, the resurrection and the life came to him that day. He was dead, and now he's alive. Thank God one day I was dead in sin. I was dead in sin. I was stinking. I was smelly. because of sin. And Jesus took me and called me by name, cleansed me, and made me whole again, and brought back life to a dead corpse. Amen. Somebody ought to shout. Somebody in here, have you been saved? Have you brought back to life? Amen. Through Jesus Christ. I am the resurrection and the life. And what made his resurrection so important than these that we just described, Lazarus? We also know that Jesus, on several occasions, he raised folks back from the dead himself. Even though they hadn't been buried, he raised Jairus' daughter up off her bed. Then he raised the son of the widow of Nain. Then he, of course, raised Lazarus here. But what made his resurrection unique from these resurrections? And the uniqueness was this. These individuals, he brought back to life. He brought back to life. And they died again. Do you follow me? These individuals had to die again, because it's appointed to man to die. And then the judgment. The uniqueness was that he rose victorious on his own accord. Nobody called him by name. And he lives forevermore. He will never die again. That's unique, amen. I am the resurrection. I am the resurrection. And I am the life. I want to talk to you about the life just for a moment, because this is where it all gets good. Good. You know, we're going to close our eyes in death here if we live long enough. Amen. If he don't come back and rapture the church, and if he comes back and rapture the church, I'm just going to be caught up, amen, as 1 Thessalonians tells, in the air. But my body is going to have to decay here on earth, because this flesh cannot, amen, inherit the incorruptible things of God. Amen. But his flesh is going back to the dust in which it came. So either way, amen, rather I get buried or rather be caught up, this body is going to be left here. But my soul will live forever and forever. Life, life. I like life, don't you? I said, don't you? You like life? You like to be living? You wouldn't like to be stuck out in a cemetery this morning, would you? Huh? Nobody wants to even entertain that thought. No, I don't want to be out there. I want to be here. I want to be living. I want to laugh with you. I want to cry with you. I want to pray with you. I want to run with you when I can. Amen? I can't run as fast as I used to. I do fast walking now. And sometimes that fast walking is slow paced, snail walking, all right? But I like to be living. I like to live. You know, there's one person in here I know likes to live, and that's Patty. Amen. She always she make you laugh, amen. When you feel down and out, she make you laugh. And glory to God, let me just tell this while I'm thinking about Patty, amen. Patty, one time we went down to Tennessee with a group of folks, amen. She dressed up like this old woman. And I went to the store for something. Next thing I know, when I come back there, she's sitting in a chair in the front of my door of the hotel room. Amen. All dressed up there. Had her legs crossed and all. And folks gathered around her. And I got her to the van. And they said, we just had to meet this woman's pastor. I said, what in the world she done to her? But she done had them laughing and carrying on. And glory to God, she loves living. And we ought to enjoy living, because God has given us life. I like living. I like being in church with y'all. I like being in church with y'all. Let me say that again. I like being in church with y'all. I hope you like being in church with me, because you stuck with me for a few minutes. Amen. Longer here. But amen, I like being in church. I like to praise God. I like to live. I like to see his beauties, amen, that he's created for me to see. I like to, amen, I like to smell the roses along the way, don't you? Glory to God, amen. Sometimes we get in so big of a hurry of life that we miss out on the most important things. And the most important things are those who are sitting around you. Hello? Those sitting around you. Jesus died for every one of them that they could have life. He said, he who believes in me will live even though he dies, and whosoever lives and believes in me will never. You get that? Never die. Look at verse 26 again. Luke 26, amen. 11, 26. John, I don't know where Luke come in there, but John 11, 26. He said, he who believes in me will live, and even though he dies, and whosoever lives and believes in me will never, never die. He said, do you believe this? See, Jesus offers us life, and the source of life is he. He is the source of life. And that's the point he was making. You believe in me, you have life. If you trust in me, you have life. Jesus says something very familiar a few chapters before in John 5:21. He said, well, just as the Father raised the dead and gives them life, even so the Son gives life to whom he pleases to give it. It is by his good graces that we have life. I said it's by his good graces we have life. In John 14, 6, I am the way, the truth, and the life. It's my good pleasure to give you life. And he wants to give whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord life today. Jesus defined eternal life quite vividly in John 17, 3 when he said this. Now this is eternal life, that they may know you, the only true God, and Jesus Christ whom you have sent. Now, this is eternal life. The life that God gives is forever and forever. So you see, the resurrection is just not a historical fact. It is more. Because he is risen, we are able to have a relationship with him. Because he is risen, he is able to touch our lives this morning. When Jesus touches our lives, he leaves an everlasting impression upon them. How many lives in here this morning has been touched by the hand of God? By the hand of God. Did he leave an everlasting impression upon your heart today? Come on, somebody. Come on. Has he touched your heart? And if he's touched your heart, let it be known. Amen. Praise him out loud. Come on, folks. Amen. Praise him out loud. If he touched your life and left an everlasting impression. When Jesus said to Martha, I am the resurrection and the life. It wasn't just a nice little theological suggestion that he was making. Rather, Jesus was presenting her with a challenge. And he's presenting us with a challenge today. Do you believe in me? And that's the last thing that he asked her. Do you believe this? Do you believe in me? When I make a claim, do you believe that claim? Do you want life? Do you want life? Do you want the life that I'm offering, Jesus said? Do you want it? Do you believe? Can I ask the same question this morning to you? Do you believe that Jesus is the resurrection and the life? Do you want the life that he is offering to you? Do you want to have that abundant life that Jesus is offering? He said, a thief cometh not but to steal and to kill and destroy. But I have come that you may have life and that you may have it, and I like this word, more abundantly. See, you ain't got to wait to get to heaven to live and to enjoy the life God wants you to have in him. It starts right here. Right now, in this very moment. See, if he just died on the cross and that was the end of it, that would have been the end of us. But it just didn't end at the cross. It was just the beginning. The cross brought forgiveness for our sin. What can wash me white as snow? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can make me whole again? nothing but the blood that was shed on that cross for you and me. He took the penalty of sin, which was death, and won victory for you and I. For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life. And that eternal life came on resurrection morning. That eternal life came on resurrection morning when he rose up out of the grave. And I like this. See, when he told Lazarus to come up out of the grave, he said, loose him and let him go, right? They had to take the grave clothes off of Lazarus. Guess what? When he come up out of the grave on his own accord, his own power, nobody took his grave clothes off. He took them off. He wrapped them up. Matter of fact, he folded them up, Ellen. He was very needful, amen? He was very tactful. He folded it up and laid it in the corner. He just didn't throw them in the floor, you know, like us young folks, you know, we used to do, just take off your clothes, throw them in the floor, and mama said, why you throw all them clothes in the floor? Make a mess. Get them clothes up out of the floor. All of them messy. You know, he folded them clothes up, the grave clothes, mind you. And he folded them up nicely and neatly and laid them in the corner. He got up out of the grave, went on. And matter of fact, the angels that came down rolled the stones away so the ladies could look in there and say, he said, come see the place where the Lord lay. He is not here, for he has risen. And he has risen indeed. Come see the place where the Lord lay. He's not here. He knew, amen. He didn't take time to roll that stone away. He just went on his business. Amen. He had the Father's business to tend to. Amen. He went on his way, and he just left the message. Amen. I rose on my own accord. I folded them clothes up nice and neatly, and I laid them over there. I'm alive, and I'm alive forevermore. And if you believe in me, you can too, because I paid the penalty for you. I died for you. I rose that you may have life. And have it more abundantly. Thank God for the resurrection. Have you believed his words today? If you could bow your head and close your eyes with me, amen. No one looking around and everyone's praying. And if you never invited Christ into your heart, friend, let me share this with you. Say, Lord Jesus, be merciful to me, a sinner, and come into my heart today. Give me that life that you talked about. I believe your word. And if you believe his word, he will grant you that life.